Question number 56. If pH of a saturated solution of MOH whole twice is 10, then the solubility product KSP of MOH whole twice will be. In this case, we have this compound and it forms these two type of ions. And if I talk about the solubility of these two, we need to just take the help from the given pH value. We know that the pH value is equal to 14 minus pOH value. From this formula, we can find out the pOH value for this saturated solution. That would be equal to 14 minus pH. It means this value would becomes 4. pOH value is 4, and if it is so, we know that pOH is negative log of OH minus ion concentration. We know that. So if pOH is 4 and if you take its anti-log, then you can get the concentration of H plus ion, OH minus ion here. So that can be written as 10 raised to the power minus 4 after taking anti-log of both the sides. So OH minus ion concentration you have here. On that basis, if this OH minus ion concentration is 10 raised to the power minus 4 molar, then on the similar basis, the concentration of M2 positive ion would be 10 raised to the power minus 4 divided by 2 molar. That we need to take here. And now KSP is the product of the solubilities of the ions. So in this way, this will becomes 10 raised to the power minus 4 divided by 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 whole square. So this would becomes 10 raised to the power minus 4 raised to the power 2, 10 raised to the power minus 8 plus minus 4. So it is 10 raised to the power minus 12. Here it is 1 by 2, so 0.5 it can be written, or it can be written as 5 into 10 raised to the power minus 13. And on that basis, the correct answer would become option 2, that you should choose as your correct answer. After this, now here is question number 57. Which among the following is a conjugate acid base pair? Suppose I have a certain acid HA. Then definitely after loss of proton, we will get its conjugate base. Here it has lost its H plus ion. It means if I talk about the first option, H2CO3 is given here. And from this H2CO3, if I remove one proton, it gets changed into HCO3 negative. That would be the conjugate base of H2CO3. So this is not representing the conjugate acid base pair. Further, H3O positive and OH minus ion. If in this base pair, if I add H plus ion, then its conjugate acid would be formed. Or from this acid H3O positive, if I remove one H plus ion, then its conjugate base would be formed. So after removal of one H plus ion from H3O positive, I'll obtain H2O, not OH minus. That's why it is also not the conjugate acid base pair. Further, I have H3PO4 and HPO4 2 negative. From H3PO4, if I remove one proton, I'll get H2PO4 negative, not HPO4 2 negative. It means this is also not the conjugate acid base pair. We have this phenoxide ion. Along with that, phenol is there. Now, from the phenol, if you remove proton, it means it gets changed into phenoxide ion this way. It means these two are representing the conjugate acid base pair. On that basis, I'll choose option 4 as the correct answer. After this, the depressant used for concentration of galena containing ZnS as impurity is. If I talk about the concentration of galena, zinc sulfide is present there as the impurity, then generally we use the depressant NaCN. This NaCN, when combined with zinc, it forms complex ion. And this gets separated during the process of concentration. So that is why option 2 becomes the correct answer. After that, question number 59. Which among the following is a nitrate ore? If I talk about the first one, that is barytes. This is the ore of barium, barium sulfate. It is sulfate ore. Further, calamine. That is ZnCO3. After that, chili saltpeter. That is sodium nitrate, NaNO3. Further, carnallite. That is KCl, MgCl2.6H2O. That is carnallite. So only one nitrate ore is here, that is chili saltpeter. That's why option 3 becomes the correct answer. Now after this, question number 60. The correct order of oxidizing power of the given ions is: oxidizing power means ability to reduce itself and to oxidize other substance. We have the different ions, ClO4 negative, then ClO3 negative, ClO2 negative and ClO negative. Among all these ions, ionic species, if we consider ClO negative, this is the least stable species. And as it is least stable species, it has more nature to be converted into the stable species by oxidizing other substance. So its oxidizing power is maximum, ClO negative. So I'm just arranging them in the order of increasing stability first, ClO negative, then ClO2 negative, after that ClO3 negative, and then there's a turn for ClO4 negative. Maximum stability is there with ClO4 negative. So its oxidizing power is least. So maximum oxidizing power, ClO negative, then this, this, and last one is this. This is the correct order. Where this order is given? This is given here in option 2. Just choose option 2 as your correct answer.